Good afternoon, TTF. My name is Max. I'm from SCB of SAM Commercial Bank. Today we will spend some minutes to update our Thai tourism outlook, and I will not go too nerdy to academic here. I will talk about what has happened, what is happening right now, and what will be happening in the future, so we all can catch the curve before it takes off, hopefully in the next few years. Okay, great. According to statistics from Tourism Ministry, 55% of all room nights or room demand in a hotel in Thailand were created by foreigners just a few years before COVID. But that 55% is just an average. If we dig deeper for some stats from Pattaya, Phuket, or Bangkok, the number could go up to 80 or 90%. Yes. So when government closed the border, that chunk of demand just gone down to zero, and that's why we are struggling right now. Okay. So as a result, last year we counted only like 6.7 million fall off all the way down from 40 million in 2019, and that is the worst level. That is the lowest level since 1995. Or 25 years ago. Yeah, so embrace that we survive. And some of you might be thinking that this is the bottom of the cliff, but it is still not, yes. And if we look at the consensus for many research houses in Thailand, consensus tells us that this year is actually the bottom of the abyss. The year that we are in right now, we can expect just somewhere below 5 million tourists. But the consensus also gave us some hope that in the next year, 2022, we can expect up to 20 million tourists incoming to Thailand. But as you know, consensus tends to change, and it depends on the situation we are facing. Like Khun Bill have said, vaccination in Thailand is rather slower than our peer competitors. So some of you might be thinking right now, how possible is it for a number of arrivals to just jump fivefold in 1 year, given that COVID is still around us? And this is made possible by some analysts because of the vaccine. As some of you might know, some rich nations like US, UK, Israel, island country, Middle Eastern country have made a very impressive progress in vaccinating their people. So when the number of people who are fully vaccinated get bigger and bigger as time goes by this year, we can expect some clarity on international tourism protocol or vaccine passport that WHO is setting up this standard. So in the second half of this year, we could expect some incoming tourists. And so at the beginning of the next year, we won't start from 1,000 each tourists like this year from the SCV. We could start from a few million tourists in the fourth quarter of this year, which give the good base for ramping up in the next year, right? And that's the foreign tourist outlook. About domestic tourism, sorry. Domestic tourism, Thailand is known for resilience. We have passed many political turbulences, tsunami, many negative events, and we always come up better. And number of domestic trips, as shown on the purple line, have shown a quick recovery after the inter-provincial lockdown has been relaxed by the government in July last year. And if you can see from the chart, the yellow line is the benchmark that you can take for a normal year, and the purple line is representing the statistic last year. You can see that the gap between the yellow line and the purple line has been narrowed down as time went by. Actually, in November, the gap was just 20% below the baseline, so we have had a good momentum right at that time before it was shut down by the second wave of domestic COVID-19. So in overall last year, the number of domestic trips have lost about half of what it was in 2019 at 166 million trips. So we have only 91 million trips in the last year. And look at the consensus, 110 million trips could be expected next year. So it's actually an increase, but not so much. And 125 million domestic trips could be expected in the next year. So it's, in overall, domestic tourism just recover gradually alongside with the domestic economy in overall. And as Thailand is known for resilience, here is the number of domestic flight passengers, which is a very high frequency data. It is published daily. So I use this as a proxy of domestic tourism recovery. And you can see from the gray line that in this round of lockdown, as we are in the late cycle of the second wave of the COVID-19 right now, number of domestic trips just have shown us again a quick recovery in March. So in this Songkran festival, which for this year is very long holiday season, we can expect some tourism vibe, especially in some destination like Pattaya, Phuket, or Hua Hin. So we can generate some cash flow and survive another season. And lastly, I will talk about NPLs because I'm from banking sector, right? In the last year, we closed the year with 4.4% of total outstanding loans as NPLs or non-performing loans. And for some of you who might not familiar with this figure, a 1/3 increase of NPL from 3.3% to 4.4% in just 1 year is considered a huge magnitude for banking sector, especially during the COVID that demand has dried up. Yeah, so 4.4% is worrisome, but for this year, the number could go up to somewhere just shy of 5%. Why? Because I believe most banks have already recalibrated the payback feasibility of their clients. Yeah, so if this year we have some negative events, like vaccination progress is slower than we expected, these NPLs could go higher than the 4.4%. And lastly, the ongoing topics in Thai tourism sector right now is the asset warehousing scheme. So in a nutshell, this scheme acts like a debt freezer that allows hotel owners to transfer the asset, the collateral to settle the outstanding loan while they still can lease the asset back for operations. And by doing this, both hotel owners and banks can stop the loan from growing bigger than the collateral, which would bring the financial collapse in the system. And also the operations that is going on will protect the asset from a quality deterioration and price crunch from the forced sale rules. Yes. So lastly, I add some reference table for you for that. In this table is key metrics. The foreign tourist arrival estimation is from my employer, SCB Economic Intelligence Center, so we can
talk.
So you can keep update the number for your analysis. But for domestic trips and NPL is my own personal view, so you can keep tracks. And this number tends to change depending on the situation. Great? Okay, that's my time. Thank you.